Tonight on Hunter.
Division commander taking on a deputy chief. You're gonna regret you ever heard my name.
Debbie, you're $500 richer. Earn it.
My whole life just kind of turned to crap.
Lovemaking, recorded secretly. My partner was a student.
Why don't you and I have a little chat?
Meet me at the observatory.
Freeze right there!
In the last 2 weeks of Hunter,
Los Angeles is a city under siege.
Hunter, I've missed you, and I'm back in town with a bang.
I mean, if you want to get a handle on why this neighborhood shivers in its sleep, a young megalomaniac punk like Youngblood is a good place to start.
As Angelinos lock their doors and wonder, where are the police?
The day after tomorrow, whoever owns that code's gonna be dead.
Freeze!
Day of execution.
Hey, hold it!
No!
You killed Alan.
I keep thinking if I'd broken cover, he'd still be alive.
65% of our fellow citizens think that Small acted in self-defense and should be released.
And in the interest of justice, the people move to dismiss all charges against the defendant.
You have my calendar, Hunter.
Yeah, I've got it right here in front of me, Iris.
Your time's coming.
You're next, Hunter.
All right.
You know, for an old guy, it still sounds like you can get it on. Too bad it was with one of your students.
It's Debbie Small.
I'm in a lot of trouble.
Debbie, you all right?
Sergeant Didi McCall, it's been nice having you at Pierce High.
I want to take Charlie out of the driver's seat and put you in it.
I really appreciate the opportunity, but stick it.
Hey, let's kill that cop tonight.
You don't have to go out looking for them. They'll be delivered to you at the hour appointed by the universe.
And now, City Under Siege, Part 3.
Is it Jack Small?
Yeah.
What next? Any suspects?
No. Some neighbors heard a scream around 6 this morning. They didn't think anything about it. They figured it was some kids playing. Till they looked out and they saw him floating face down in the pool. Yeah.
Revenge for the Marshall killing, you think?
I don't know. I asked DHQ to go over and interview his parents.
Good, good. What about Small's daughter, Debbie? Isn't that her name? She know anything about this?
She's unaccounted for. I had Brendan check the apartment. Nothing.
Chief, we understand the victim has been identified as Jack Small. Now, shouldn't you have anticipated an attempt on his life?
Well, we're fully aware of the controversy surrounding Jack Small. I presume that he didn't ask for protection. However, if there's any dereliction of duty, you have my word that whoever is responsible will face the consequences. Thank you very much. Excuse me.
One more question.
Ray. Here comes the prince of the city.
Yeah. Now, what do you got? Don't color it.
Stabbed to death. No wits, no suspects.
Huh? Tell me something. What did you do before you became a cop?
I was a secretary.
Good. You'll have something to fall back on.
Excuse me.
Well, another stellar performance by your people. Why wasn't Small provided with protection?
He had plenty of protection while he was still in the county jail.
Are you suggesting my complicity in his release?
I know Ed Clayton. He's a damn good prosecutor. He wouldn't roll over on a case like this unless he'd been persuaded.
Devane, you've been skating on thin ice for some time now. And the task force has fallen on its collective ass. And because of your incompetent leadership, the department is under severe criticism. Our reputation is number one. Well, say it suffered. I think it's time that we relieve you of your responsibilities, bring in some new blood.
I know all about your offer to Hunter. It's about what I'd expect from you. You know, Curtis, you've made a career out of bobbing and weaving, making sure the stink doesn't stick to you. Well, I promise you, I am going to find out who is responsible for putting Jack Small back on the street. And when I do, I'll bet you a barrel of Powers Irish you don't survive the scrutiny.
Now, you say that you saw a man running away?
Yes, he had something shiny in his hand. I think it was a knife.
Can you describe him for me?
I already have for Sergeant Hunter.
For Sergeant Hunter? What do you mean?
You should have his picture. Your artist drew him last week.
Is this the man that you saw?
It's him. Do you think he might come back here?
No, Mrs. Fleck, I wouldn't worry about that. You'll be all right. Greg, take Mrs. Fleck inside. Tell the watch commander I want her checked hourly. You'll be fine. Debbie! Debbie?
I don't understand. Why do they do that?
I don't know.
Last month, on my 18th birthday, he gave me this teddy bear, and I thought it was really stupid. He just wanted me to be a little girl.
Why don't we go inside where we can talk?
Hi.
Hi.
Debbie, is there anything that I can do for you?
Look, I just think I need to be alone.
Deb,
I'll be all right, really.
I think we need to talk.
What about?
A lot.
Well, I have some free time this afternoon.
Good. Come by my office.
Downtown store owner thinks he made Billy off the bulletin we distributed. First in Adams.
Thanks, Ray.
Yeah, hell. I saw him on the news just the other night. I think they're staying right over there.
Hotel Baltimore?
Yeah.
You sure that's them?
I'm sure. I've seen him more than I've seen her, but that's the guy that bought the knife.
Thanks. Appreciate it.
Yeah, no problem.
This is 1 William 156. I am at 1st and Adams Street. Request a plainclothes backup in the rear of the Hotel Baltimore. Possible 187 suspect, code 2.
Roger, 1 William 156.
In other news, the victim in last night's Valley slaying has been identified as Jack Small, the so-called North Hollywood vigilante. He was arrested earlier this week as a suspect in the tragic death of Pierce High School student Alan Marshall. Many Valley residents were outraged when manslaughter charges
outraged?
Small were unexpectedly
you bet.
Dropped. Police have refused to speculate as to a motive in Small's murder and reported they have no active suspects.
It's because you're all a bunch of dummies.
I appreciate your willingness to speak with me. You understand, of course, that I will be recording everything we say.
Do you have to? I understand.
And since I read you your rights, you are under no obligation to speak with me.
Yes, I know. Please have a seat.
Okay, what do you need to speak with me about?
Well, to begin with, you were right. Youngblood did force me to tell him that you were a cop.
Forced you how?
His stock in trade.
What's that?
Lovemaking. Recorded secretly at my bedroom. Alan Marshall was probably in my apartment on Friday night in order to recover the tape recorder.
Well, I can understand how that would be embarrassing for you, but...
My partner was a student.
What was the student's name?
Debbie Small. Look, it's not at all what you think it is. As a matter of fact, it started very innocently. Her father never gave her so much as a second of his time. All she needed was someone to talk to, someone to turn to, and... Well, I mean, we went for walks, we went jogging, we snuck out to the movies a few times. All I really wanted to do was to take her into my arms and to protect her. And then one thing led to another. She is 18. She's a woman, Sergeant McCall.
She just turned 18 last month, Landry. How long have you been involved with her?
A year.
How did Youngblood find out about it?
She must have told him. Maybe when she was stoned, maybe in order to prove to him that she was worth something. I don't know.
Or maybe to get something from him.
What happens to me now?
Well, you could be charged with statutory rape. That depends upon the DA. The question is, what happens to Debbie now?
William Joseph Powell. Ira Smith. These are the two people we're looking for. Now, I don't know if they're in the hotel or not. I don't know if they're together or they're separate. They're armed and dangerous. Brennan, why don't you stay here? Keep an eye on the back of the building. Al, why don't you come with me, huh? They're low. Get ready. Sergeant Hunter, LA Police Department. Ever see those two people before?
I don't know.
William Joseph Powell, Ira Smith. Take another look, please.
Yeah, they look like the Joneses.
The Joneses. Are they in their room?
How the hell do I know?
What room are they registered under?
411.
411.
Trouble on the way. I told them you were in 411.
Okay, thanks.
Shots. What's going on? Talk to me. What's going on?
Brennan is coming out.
We got an officer down.
What the hell are you calling me out here for?
Chief, tell me something. You were captain down in San Pedro about 8 years ago, weren't you?
Yeah, I know where I was 8 years ago, Charlie. The question is, what am I doing here now?
You had some business with Ed Clayton then, didn't you?
Ah, that's it, huh? Yeah. That's why you didn't want to talk in the office. Okay, this better be good.
I was looking through his personnel file. About 8 years ago, he was arrested by one of your traffic officers and then released without explanation. You mind telling me why?
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Well, the way Clayton rolled over on the Jack Small case, you'd think that someone had him on a really short leash. Someone like you, maybe?
You're tilting at windmills, Charlie. I had nothing to do with Jack Small's release.
Well, I intend to look very carefully into his professional life until I get an answer.
You leave Clayton out of this. You're wasting the department's time and mine.
Would I be wasting IAD's time?
You want to go to internal affairs? I'll hold the door open for you. And I'll show you the way to personnel, where you can turn in your ID and resign in lieu of whatever.
In lieu of nothing. You're not going to force me out. If you want me out, you'll have to go the whole route. And while you're out trumping up some disciplinary action against me, I'm going to nail you with one that sticks.
What are you playing at? A division commander taking on a deputy chief? Forget it, Charlie. Because you're going to lose. And you're going to regret you ever heard my name.
Commander 1 William, come in, please. Commander 1 William, respond.
1 William, go.
We have a report of an officer-involved shooting near 5th and Los Angeles Streets. One officer killed, another wounded.
What about the shooter?
Sergeant Hunter was reported to be involved in a foot pursuit of the suspect.
Get an air unit over there right away. I'm on my way.
Roger.
I'll see you there.
All right, I'll handle it from the task force room.
Didn't you hear what they said? One dead, one wounded. Don't you care about your men? Or do you only show up for the cameras when we win?
sir.
So why did that old guy send you to the wrong room?
Powell told him he'd cut his throat if he didn't lie for him.
And the cop's dead.
Captain, Deputy Chief Moorhead wants to see you. He's in your office.
Swell.
Captain. Sergeant.
We have things we could be doing.
So do I. Spending half my day fending off reporters is not in my job description.
I think if you stopped hobnobbing at those press luncheons, Chief, and start paying attention to what this department goes through on a daily basis, you might have a different impression about the people who serve this city. And then maybe we all should stand back and take a long, hard look at your job.
Hunter, I didn't dismiss you.
He's got a lot of work to do.
Damn it, Devane. This city is expecting things to happen.
You're the one who made the promises, Chief.
Well, let me clue you in. Somebody's going to take a fall as soon as the good folks up above decide they need a scapegoat. And you can be damn sure it isn't going to be me.
Don't bet on it.
Hi.
Thanks for coming.
I was glad you called. Packing up, moving out?
Yeah, my mom's gonna be here in a few days to take care of things, whatever that means. She wants me to pack everything up.
How you feeling?
Okay, I guess. You heard about me and Vice Principal Landry?
Yeah, he told me.
Probably think I'm pretty stupid, huh?
No. I saw the tape that you made with Johnny.
I'm sorry.
Sorry I saw it or sorry you did it?
Both. I tried to get it back. I even
told Johnny about you and Roger. You set me up at the gym, too, didn't you?
I'm sorry. I'm really sorry. My whole life just kind of turned to crap. I'm, oh, yeah, let's go have fun with the friends and everything, but it's like nobody really talks to me or knows what I am or what matters to me.
I guess you're the only person that really knows that. You know, Debbie, if it means anything, I happen to think you're a good person. You've got a good heart.
Deep down inside, underneath all that other stuff.
Well, you may have made a few mistakes along the way, yeah. But I think you've got what it takes to turn your life around. I really do.
Thanks, I'll give it a shot.
Good.
Charlie.
Hi, Ed, sit down. Kind of wish I could open a secondary office out here. It's kind of nice, you know?
So, Charlie, something you didn't want to deal with back at the ranch?
Yeah. Yeah, I want to talk about a night 8 years ago in San Pedro when a young up-and-coming assistant DA got drunk and took out two lampposts and an RTD bus stop.
Yeah.
Or more to the point, what happened afterwards? When the then Captain Moorhead kicked him loose for future favors.
Who are you talking to, Charlie?
Talk to Carlos Espinada, the arresting officer.
He's retired now.
Yeah, he didn't even remember it, but I waded through about 5 miles of microfilm to find the original traffic violation.
Charlie, Did you ever do something so unbelievably stupid that you just wish you could take it back? Cut out that hour, that minute, even the seconds of your life? Well, Curtis Moorhead, he did that for me. My career would have gone down the tubes. He arranged to spring me without anybody the wiser. Charlie, I didn't have any choice. I couldn't say no.
So 8 years later, he involves you in a conspiracy to obstruct justice, and you still don't say no.
Charlie, I'm telling you, he still got me. There was nothing else I could have done.
Another career decision? Now look, Ed, I know you're not a crook. I know there's nothing basically corrupt about you. You made a bad mistake. But Moorhead is a different story. He and his type, they cheapen everything that we do, everything we stand for. And I'll tell you something, they will destroy us too, if we give them half a chance. I'm going after him. It'll be a hell of a lot easier with you standing next to me. But either way, I'm gonna get him. Hunter, homicide.
Wasn't too cool what you did, Rick.
Wasn't too cool at all.
Well, that's how I treat all my murderers, Iris. That's the way it goes.
It's time.
Why don't you and I have a little chat?
Yeah, let's. Meet me at the observatory. You know when, if you've done your homework.
This morning in the school parking lot.
Debbie, I'm not really interested in your personal problems.
I need money, Johnny.
So what am I, a bank?
Can we just talk, please?
Okay, I'm about 5 minutes away.
Thanks.
Yeah. Hello.
Yeah, Lenny, it's Youngblood.
Anything shaking?
Yeah. You think you could, another grand?
You got something for me?
Yeah, we'll just call it a bonus tape.
You got it working, huh?
Yeah, I'm on my way to a pre-production meeting right now.
Meet you at your place with the cash.
Debbie? What are you doing out here?
I got something I gotta do.
Are you all right?
I'm fine.
Look at me, will you please? I'm real sorry about everything that's been happening to you. I think when you're up to it, we should talk.
Sure.
I care about you. You know that, don't you?
right. You want to get whatever is on your mind over with as quickly as possible.
Morning, Chief. Did you eat yet?
I have lunch, and you got exactly 5 minutes.
I don't think I'm going to need even that much time.
All right, then get on with it.
8 years ago, you were a captain down in San Pedro, right?
Yeah, we've been all over that.
Not the good part. Because I believe your whole career is one long trail of manipulative corruption.
You want a turkey shoot, Devane? Well, you're in the wrong neck of the woods.
I don't think so. I finally found out why Ed Clayton was arrested. DUI, into some county property. Starting to sound familiar. So, an up-and-coming assistant DA drinks too much, gets involved in an accident that could end his career. Suddenly, he's reprieved. He must have been very grateful.
I wouldn't know.
Let's ask the DA.
Clayton, I don't know what kind of delusion you're under here, but if you want to come down to my office and talk it over.
We've talked enough. It's over, Curtis.
Nothing's ever over. Things change, and I adjust. You want to tell them that I blackmailed you? That I forced you to do what I want in order to bring some kind of order into this totally chaotic bureaucracy?
Something like that, yeah.
Well, then you're going to have to prove it, gentlemen, because I'm going to deny it all. And I got a lot of colleagues in very, very tall positions that are going to back me up.
Chief, I'd like you to meet Officers Pitts and Johnson. They're from Internal Affairs. I think you better cancel that lunch.
I just need a couple $100. I'll pay you back.
I'm offering you $500, and you can keep it.
Johnny, please.
Damn it, Debbie. You've done this before. What the hell do you care? I'm talking $500 cash, and all you gotta do is the only thing you can do halfway decent. Look, don't give me those phony tears. You know what you are, and you're never gonna change. So smoke some dope, kick back. We'll make a movie and you can be on your merry way. Clean up your act. That's your cash.
Dude, what's up?
Hey, Johnny.
So are we on?
You got the money? So, you want to stick around, or you want a messenger service?
Yeah, I guess I could stick around for a little while.
Debbie, you're $500 richer. Earn it.
Thank you.
Put your hands behind your head, lace your fingers behind your neck, you're under arrest.
Now, what the hell for?
Well, let's try, for starters, transportation of pornography across state lines and possession of illegal drugs. I'm gonna kick you so hard, you'd wish today was a bad dream. Get him out of here.
Come on, let's move it. You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say can and will.
Had to wait till he brought out the money.
I know.
He did good. Took a lot of guts to put on a wire and come in here.
I'm just glad it's all over. Thanks.
Yeah. Come on.
Right on time, Iris, just like the calendar said.
Yeah, timing's everything, isn't it, Hunter?
You're under arrest. I want you to let the hostage go, put your gun on the ground. Do it, Iris! Enough innocent people have died already.
Nobody's innocent.
Tonight on Hunter.
Division commander taking on a deputy chief. You're gonna regret you ever heard my name.
Debbie, you're $500 richer. Earn it.
My whole life just kind of turned to crap.
Lovemaking, recorded secretly. My partner was a student.
Why don't you and I have a little chat?
Meet me at the observatory.
Freeze right there!
We'll be right back.
in the last 2 weeks of Hunter.
Los Angeles is a city under siege.
Hunter, I've missed you, and I'm back in town with a bang.
I mean, if you want to get a handle on why this neighborhood shivers in its sleep, a young megalomaniac punk like Youngblood is a good place to start.
As Angelinos lock their doors and wonder, where are the police?
The day after tomorrow, whoever owns that code's gonna be dead.
Freeze!
Stay of execution.
Hey! Hold it.
No! You killed Alan.
I keep thinking if I'd broken cover, he'd still be alive.
65% of our fellow citizens think that Small acted in self-defense and should be released.
And in the interest of justice, the people move to dismiss all charges against the defendant.
You have my calendar, Hunter.
Yeah, I've got it right here in front of me, Iris.
Your time's coming.
You're next, Hunter!
All right.
You know, for an old guy, it still sounds like you can get it on. Too bad it was with one of your students.
It's Debbie Small.
I'm in a lot of trouble.
Debbie, you all right?
Sergeant Dee Dee McCall, it's been nice having you at Pierce High.
Take Charlie out of the driver's seat and put you in it.
I really appreciate the opportunity, but stick it.
Hey, let's kill that cop tonight.
You don't have to go out looking for them. They'll be delivered to you at the hour appointed by the universe.
And now, City Under Siege, Part 3.
Jack Small?
Yeah.
What next? Any suspects?
No. Some neighbors heard a scream around 6 this morning. They didn't think anything about it. They figured it was some kids playing. Till they looked out and they saw him floating face down in the pool. Yeah.
Revenge for the Marshall killing, you think?
I don't know. I asked DHQ to go over and interview his parents.
Good, good.
What about Small's daughter, Debbie? Isn't that her name? She know anything about this?
She's unaccounted for. I had Brendan check the apartment. Nothing.
Chief, we understand the victim has been identified as Jack Small. Now, shouldn't you have anticipated an attempt on his life?
Well, we're fully aware of the controversy surrounding Jack Small. I presume that he didn't ask for protection. However, if there's any dereliction of duty, you have my word that whoever is responsible will face the consequences. Thank you very much. Excuse me.
One more question.
Oh, Ray. Here comes the prince of the city.
Well, what do you got? Don't color it.
Stabbed to death. No wits, no suspects.
Huh? Tell me something. What did you do before you became a cop?
I was a secretary.
Good. You'll have something to fall back on.
Excuse me.
Well, another stellar performance by your people. Why wasn't Small provided with protection?
He had plenty of protection while he was still in the county jail.
Are you suggesting my complicity in his release?
I know Ed Clayton. He's a damn good prosecutor. He wouldn't roll over on a case like this unless he'd been persuaded.
Devane, you've been skating on thin ice for some time now. And the task force has fallen on its collective ass. And because of your incompetent leadership, the department is under severe criticism. Our reputation is number one. Well, say it's suffered. I think it's time that we relieve you of your responsibilities, bring in some new blood.
I know all about your offer to Hunter. It's about what I'd expect from you. You know, Curtis, you've made a career out of bobbing and weaving, making sure the stink doesn't stick to you. Well, I promise you, I am going to find out who is responsible for putting Jack Small back on the street. And when I do, I'll bet you a barrel of Powers Irish you don't survive the scrutiny.
Now, you say that you saw a man running away?
Yes, he had something shiny in his hand. I think it was a knife.
Can you describe him for me?
I already have for Sergeant Hunter.
For Sergeant Hunter? What do you mean?
You should have his picture. Your artist drew him last week.
Is this the man that you saw?
It's him. Do you think he might come back here?
No, Mrs. Fleck, I wouldn't worry about that. You'll be all right. Greg, take Mrs. Fleck inside. Tell the watch commander I want her checked hourly. You'll be fine. Debbie. Debbie?
I don't understand. Why do they do that?
I don't know.
Last month on my 18th birthday, he gave me this teddy bear and I thought it was really stupid. He just wanted me to be a little girl.
Why don't we go inside where we can talk?
Hi.
Hi.
Debbie, is there anything that I can do for you?
Look, I just think I need to be alone.
Deb,
I'll be all right, really.
I think we need to talk.
What about?
A lot.
I have some free time this afternoon.
Good. Come by my office.
Downtown store owner thinks he made Billy off the bulletin we distributed. First in Adams.
Thanks, Rick.
Yeah, hell. I saw him on the news just the other night. I think they're staying right over there.
Hotel Baltimore?
Yeah.
You sure that's them?
I'm sure. I've seen him more than I've seen her. But that's the guy that bought the knife.
Thanks. Appreciate it.
Yeah, no problem.
This is one, William 156. I am at 1st and Adams Street. Request a plainclothes backup in the rear of the Hotel Baltimore. Possible 187 suspect, code 2.
Roger, 1 William 156. In other news, the victim in last night's Valley slaying has been identified as Jack Small, the so-called North Hollywood vigilante. He was arrested earlier this week as a suspect in the tragic death of Pierce High School student Alan Marshall. Many Valley residents were outraged when manslaughter charges
outraged?
In Small were unexpectedly you bet. Dropped. Police have refused to speculate as to a motive in Small's murder and reported they have no active suspects.
That's because you're all a bunch of dummies.
I appreciate your willingness to speak with me. You understand, of course, that I will be recording everything we say.
Do you have to? I understand.
And since I read you your rights, you are under no obligation to speak with me.
Yes, I know. Please have a seat.
Okay, what do you need to speak with me about?
Well, to begin with, you were right. Youngblood did force me to tell him that you were a cop.
Forced you how?
His stock in trade.
What's that?
Lovemaking. Recorded secretly at my bedroom. Alan Marshall was probably in my apartment on Friday night in order to recover the tape recorder.
Well, I can understand how that would be embarrassing for you, but...
My partner was a student.
What was the student's name?
Debbie Small. Look, it's not at all what you think it is. As a matter of fact, it started very innocently. Her father never gave her so much as a second of his time. All she needed was someone to talk to, someone to turn to, and... Well, I mean, we went for walks, we went jogging, we snuck out to the movies a few times. All I really wanted to do was to take her into my arms and to protect her.